नमस्कार, माय नेम इज समीर साके दीवान, असिस्टेंट टीचर इन रतुड़िया प्राथमिक शाला, तिलकवाड़ा, नर्मदा। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फिफ्थ चैप्टर ऑफ नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी 2020, टीचर्स। Teachers truly shape the future of our children and therefore the future of our nation. It is because of this noblest role that the teacher in India was the most respected member of society. Only the very best and most learned became teachers. Society gave teachers or gurus what they needed to pass on their knowledge, skills, and ethics optimally to students. The quality of teacher education, requirement, deployment, service conditions, and empowerment of teachers is not where it should be. And consequently, the quality and motivation of teachers does not reach the desired standards. The high respect for teachers and the high status of teaching profession must be restored so as to inspire the best to enter the teaching profession. The motivation and empowerment of teachers is required to ensure the best possible future for our children and our nation. Recruitment and deployment. To ensure that outstanding students enter the teaching profession, especially from rural areas, a large number of merit-based scholarships shall be instituted across the country for studying quality four-year integrated B.Ed. programs. In rural areas, special merit-based scholarships will be established that also include preferential employment in their local areas upon successful completion of their B.Ed. programs. Such scholarships will provide local jobs opportunities to local students, especially female students, so that these students serve as local area role models and as highly qualified teachers who speak the local language. Incentives will be provided for teachers to take up teaching jobs in rural areas, especially in areas that are currently facing acute shortage of quality teachers. A key incentive for teaching in rural schools will be the provision of local housing near or on the school premises or increased housing allowance. The harmful practice of excessive teacher transfer will be halted so that students have continuity in their role models and educational environments. Transfers will occur in very special circumstances, as suitably laid down in a structural manner by state or union territory governments. Furthermore, transfer will be conducted through an online computerized system that ensures transparency. Teacher eligibility test will be strengthened to inculcate better test material, both in terms of content and pedagogy. The teacher eligibility test will also be extended to cover teachers across all stages, fundamentals, preparatory, middle, and secondary of school education. For subject teachers, suitable TET or NTA test scores in the corresponding subjects will also be taken into account for requirement. To gauge passion and motivation for teaching, a classroom demonstration or interview will become an integral part of teacher hiring at schools and school complexes. These interviews would also be used to assess comfort and proficiency in teaching in the local language so that every school or school complex has at least some teachers who can converse with students in the local language and other prevalent home languages of students. Teachers in private schools also must have qualified similar through teacher eligibility test, a demonstration or interview, and knowledge of local languages. To ensure an adequate number of teachers across subject, particularly in subjects such as art, physical education, vocational education, and languages, teachers could be required to a school or school complex, and the sharing of teachers across schools could be considered in accordance with grouping of schools adopted by state or union territory governments. Schools or school complexes will be encouraged to hire local eminent person or expert as master instructors in various subjects such as in traditional local arts, vocational crafts, entrepreneurship, agriculture, or any other subjects where local expertise exists, to benefit students and help preserve and promote local knowledge and professions. A technology-based comprehensive teachers' requirement planning for forecasting exercise will be conducted by each state to assess expected subject-wise teachers' vacancies over the next two decades. The described initiatives in recruitment and deployment will be scaled as needed over time to fill all vacancies with qualified teachers, including local teachers, with suitable incentives for career management and progression as described. Teacher education programs and offering will also align with the vacancies thus projected. Service environment and culture. The primary goal of overhauling the service environment and culture of school will be to maximize the ability of teachers to do their jobs effectively and to ensure that they are part of vibrant, caring, and inclusive communities of teachers, students, parents, principals, and other support staff, all of whom share a common goal to ensure that our children are learning. The first requirement in this direction will be to ensure decent and pleasant service condition at school. Adequate and safe infrastructure including working toilets, clean drinking water, clean and attractive spaces, electricity, computing devices, internet, library, and sports and recreational resources will be provided to all schools to ensure that teachers and students, including children of all genders and children with disabilities, receive a safe, inclusive, and effective learning environment and are comfortable and inspired to teach and learn in the schools. In-service training will have inputs on safety, health, and environment at workplace in schools to ensure that all teachers are sanitized to these requirements. State or union territory governments may adopt innovative formats such as school complex, rationalization of schools without in any way reducing accessibility for effective school governance, resource sharing and community building. The creation of school complexes could go a long way towards building vibrant teacher communities. The hiring of teachers to school complexes could automatically create relationships among schools across the school complex. It would also help ensure excellent subject-wise distribution of teachers, creating a more vibrant teacher knowledge base. Teachers at very small schools will not remain isolated any longer and may become part of and work with larger school complex communities, sharing best practice with each other and working collaboratively to ensure that all children are learning. School complexes could also share counselors, trained social workers, technical and maintenance staff, etc., to further support and help create an effective learning environment. In collaboration with parents and other key local stakeholders, teachers will also be more involved in the governance of school or school complexes, including as member of the school management committee or school complex management committees. To prevent the large amounts of time spent currently by teachers on non-teaching activities, teachers will not be engaged any longer in work that is not directly related to teaching. In particular, teachers will not be involved in strenuous administrative tasks and more than a rationalized minimum time for midday meal related work, so that they may fully concentrate on their teaching learning duties. To help ensure that schools have positive learning environments, the role expectations of principals and teachers will explicitly include developing a caring, inclusive culture at schools for effective learning and benefit of all stakeholders. Teachers will be given more autonomy in choosing aspect of pedagogy so that they may teach in the manner they find most effective for the students in their classrooms. Teachers will also focus on social-emotional learning, a critical aspect of any student's holistic development. Teachers will be recognized for novel approaches to teaching that improve learning outcomes in their classrooms. Continuous professional development. Teachers will be given continuous opportunity for self-improvement and to learn the latest innovations and advances in their professions. This will be offered in multiple modes, including in the form of school, regional, state, national, and international workshops, as well as online teacher development modules. Platforms, especially online platforms, will be developed so that teachers may share ideas and best practices. Each teacher will be expected to participate in at least 50 hours of continuous professional development opportunities every year for their own professional development, driven by their own interest. Continuous professional development opportunities will in particular systematically cover the latest pedagogies regarding fundamentals, literacy and numeracy. Formative and adaptive assessment of learning outcomes, competency-based learning and related pedagogies such as experiential learning, arts integrated, sport integrated and storytelling based opportunities, etc. School principals and school complex leaders will have similar modular leadership management, workshops and online development opportunities and platforms to continuously improve their own leadership and management skills, and so that they too many share best practices with each other. Such leaders will also be expected to participate in 50 hours of more of continuous professional development modules per year, covering leadership and management as well as content and pedagogy, with a focus on preparing and implementing pedagogical plans based on competency-based education. Career management and progression. Teachers doing outstanding work must be recognized and promoted and given salary raises to incentivize all teachers to do their best work. Therefore, a robust merit-based structure of tenure, promotion, and salary structure will be developed, with multiple levels within each teacher stage that incentivizes and recognizes outstanding teachers. A system of multiple parameters for proper assessment of performance will be developed for the same by state or union territory governments, that is, based on peer reviews, attendance, commitments, hours of continuous professional development and other forms of service to the school and the community, or based on NPST given in paragraph 5.20. In this policy, in the context of careers, tenure refers to confirmation for permanent employment after due assessment of performance and contribution, while tenure track refers to the period of probation preceding tenure. Further, it will be ensured that career growth in terms of tenure, promotion, salary increases, etc. is available to teachers with a single school stage, foundational, preparatory, middle or secondary, and that there is no career progression related incentive to move from being teachers in early stages to later stages or vice versa, though such career moves across stages will be allowed, provided the teacher has the desired and qualifications for such a move. This is to support the fact that all stages of school education will require the highest quality teachers, and no stage will be considered more important than any other. Vertical mobility of teachers based on merit will also be paramount. Outstanding teachers with demonstrated leadership and management skill would be trained over time to take an academic leadership positions in schools. Such school complexes, BRCs, CRCs, BITs, DITs, EDs, FELAS, relevant government department. Professional standards for teachers. A common guiding set of national professional standards for teachers will be developed by 2022 by the National Council for Teacher Education in its restructured new forms as a professional standard setting body. under the General Education Council in consultation with NCERT, SCERTs, teachers from across levels and regions, expert organizations in teacher preparation and development, expert bodies in vocational education and higher education institutions. The standard would cover expectations of the role of the teacher at different levels of expertise or stages, and the competencies required for stage. It will also comprise standards for performance appraisal for each stage that would be carried out on a periodic basis. The NPST will also inform the design of pre-service teacher education programs. This could be then adopted by states and determine all aspects of teacher career management, including tenure, professional development efforts, salary increases, promotions, and other recognitions. The professional standards will be reviewed and revised in 2030, and thereafter every 10 years on the basis of rigorous empirical analysis of the efficacy of the system. Special educators. There is an urgent need for additional special educators for certain areas of school education. Some examples of such specialist requirements include subject teaching for children with disabilities or Divyang children at the middle and secondary school level, including teaching for specific learning disabilities. Such teachers would require not only subject teaching knowledge and understanding of subject-related aims of education, but also the relevant skills for understanding of special requirements of children. Therefore, such areas could be developed as secondary specializations for subject teachers or generalist teachers during or after pre-service teacher preparations. They will be offered as certificate courses in the pre-service as well as in-service mode, either full-time or as part-time or blended courses again, necessarily at multidisciplinary colleges or universities. Greater synergy will be enabled between the course curriculum of NCTE and RCI to ensure adequate availability of qualified special educators who can handle subject teaching as well. Approach to teacher education. Recognizing that the teachers will require training in high quality content as well as pedagogy, teacher education will gradually be moved by 2030 into multidisciplinary colleges and universities. As colleges and universities all move towards becoming multidisciplinary, they will also aim to house outstanding education departments that offer B.Ed., M.Ed. And Ph.D. degree in education. By 2030, the minimum degree qualification for teaching will be a 4-year integrated B.Ed. degree that teaches a range of knowledge, content, and pedagogy, and includes strong practicum training in the form of student teaching at local school. The 2-year B.Ed. programs will also be offered by the same multidisciplinary institutions offering the 4-year integrated B.Ed. and will be intended only for those who have already obtained bachelor degrees in other specialized subjects. These B.Ed. programs may also be suitably adopted as one-year B.Ed programs and will be offered only to those who have completed the equivalent of 4-year multidisciplinary bachelor's degrees or who have obtained a master's degree in a specialty and wish to become a subject teacher in that specialty. All such B.Ed degrees would be offered only by accredited multidisciplinary higher education institutions offering 4-year integrated B.Ed programs. Multidisciplinary higher education institutions offering the 4-year in-class integrated B.Ed programs and having accreditation for ODL may also offer high quality B.Ed programs in blended or ODL mode to students to remote or difficult to access locations and also to in-service teachers who are aiming to enhance their qualifications with suitable robust arrangements for mentoring and further practicum training and student teaching components of the program. All B.Ed programs will include training in time-tested as well as the most recent techniques in pedagogy, including pedagogy with respect to foundational literacy and numeracy, multi-level teaching and evaluation, teaching children with disabilities, teaching children with special interest or talents, use of educational technology and learner-centered and collaborative learning. All B.Ed programs will include strong practicum training in form of in-class teaching at local schools. All B.Ed programs will also emphasize the practice of the fundamental duties, Article 51A, of the Indian Constitution along with other constitutional provisions while teaching any subject or performing any activities. It will also appropriately integrate environmental awareness and sensitivity towards its conservation and sustainable development so that environment education becomes an integral part of school curricula. Shorter post-B.Ed certification courses will also be made widely available at multidisciplinary colleges and universities to teachers who may wish to move into more specialized area of teaching, such as the teaching of students with disabilities or into leadership and management positions in the schooling system, or to move from one to another between foundational, preparatory, middle and secondary stages. It is recognized that there may be several pedagogical approaches internationally for teaching particular subjects. NCERT will study research documents and compile the varied international pedagogical approaches for teaching different subjects and make recommendations on what can be learned, and it is recognized that there may be several pedagogical opportunities internationally for teaching particular subjects. NCERT will study research documents and compile the varied international pedagogical opportunities for teaching different subjects and make recommendations on what can be learned and assimilated for these opportunities into the pedagogies being practiced in India. By 2021, a new and comprehensive national curriculum framework for teacher education, NCFTE 2021, will be formulated by the NCTE in consultation with NCERT based on principles of this National Education Policy 2020. The framework will be developed after discussion with all stakeholders, including state governments, relevant ministries or departments of central government, and various expert bodies, and will be made available in all regional languages. The NCFTE 2021 will also factor in the requirement of teacher education curricula for vocational education. Finally, in order to fully restore the integrity of teacher education system, stringent action will be taken against substandard alone teacher education institutions running in the country, including shutting them down if required. Thanks for watching this video.